These are the hooks where you are going to hook it up for this one. How to check the function of the hooks, that this is working properly or not. You have to just keep your thumb on the back side and here, and then just press from here and see it's a mechanism. So it is working. If you want to press only this portion, it will not work. So this is your safety. And this is called the reverse, to check the safety is working or not. Simply press this area. If it is moving or coming back, so means it's useless. So you have to remove this one. It will open only with the disassembly. Once you will push this one lock, so the safety latch will be open. So this is called the functional test. So you have to do the functional test for your hook. Now, these hook, these are attached through a web sling to the shock absorber. So you have to check the sling as well. There should be no abrasion, nor acid damage, nor no heat damage, no cut, no protrusion or no puncture should be there. It should be in a good condition, and then the shock absorber, it should be like this. Yes.
Do we have any load capacity of these legs, and how much load we can take for any IP?
Load, no. Actually, it is designed for a single man. Okay, and there is SWL is there, up to 250 or 300 you can take, means that people, yeah. So this is designed only for, yeah, designed for a one person. But you cannot use for two person, or you cannot use this safety harness for material. This is only a PPE for the men or the personnel who are going to use this one. So once you will check, yeah, this is working, and once you will put it on a lock position, now it is locked. So means it is functioning well. So only you have to check. Now this on this side. Here I will adjust. Okay. And I will lock. Now I will check it again. Double check. It's okay. Now this is the full safety harness assembly for a person who is going to make entry in a confined space. Okay, in the attachment of the lander. Okay, now how to carry this one? So many people, they are keeping like this and they are walking. Huh? This is not a safe practice. Might be it will be endangered or equipped with some equipment or tools, so it will give you a heart. So there are so many techniques you can utilize. Either you, if you can make one round, okay, or you can have a round like this, and then you can buckle it up over here. Okay, so if you can make one turn and then like this.
I just want plastic.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
Or you can make one first round with the vest. If it is more than your length, then you have to keep like this. The purpose is it should not be kept on the ground or on your shoulder that you are going, and it is restricting or affecting with some equipment or some ID. So this is the proper use of a safety harness with this attachment over here. So in case of if he is working and if he is getting falling down from height, so this is the shock absorber who will take all the load. And the second thing, if he is working in a confined space and you are going to use the tripod medium or any crane to lift it up from the down to the top, okay, so simply you have to attach the hook of the tripod or a crane over here, or you can attach it over here and it will be down. So this one you can attach with the far rester as well, as a double safety. For example, if one medium is going to fail, the second device is there for the rester. We will demonstrate you on the exact location for the simulator later also. Okay.
I have a question, please, Mubashir.
Yes.
Regarding this shock absorber, what is the minimum height that is required for this shock absorber to be activated in case of falling down?
Yeah, actually this depends upon, first of all, your the platform height.
Yeah.
Okay, what is the platform height? Now, in the wheel procedure, if it is, you are saying work at height involves safety hardness, means if it is above 2 meter, you need a scaffolding. So for sure you need this one, the safety hardness as well.
But now, if for example, he is working at a platform which is 4 meters height.
Yeah.
And he is anchoring himself to a stable structure.
Yes.
Concrete structure with a nail and whatsoever.
Yeah.
In case of falling down from a height of 4 meters, do you think this shock absorber will be activated? It will have some action?
No, it depends upon your anchoring point. For example, if you are, your total height is a 4 meter, okay, and the lanyard meter is also 4 meter or 3 meter, and you are hooking it up, so no, it will not be activated. Once you will fell down, immediately you will come on the ground. So it has to be above your height. For example, you have to activate at least 1 meter or up to 2 meter. So if you will fall down from the height, so you will be in a hanging position. You will not touch the ground, okay? Now the thing is, once you will read the tag or the label on the lanyard, it will give you what is the length. For example, if there is a 3 meter length, okay, once you will fall down, then it, the shock absorber will start to loose, okay? And once it will be open, fully open, so then the total length will be the 3 meter. You understand? So you have to calculate your platform height, plus you have to keep the margin, and then you have to hook it up above your head. So if you will fall down and the shock absorber will start work, and you know it will be open and the total length will be the 3, okay? So 3 plus 2 means 5. You have minimum 5 meter height, means 2 meter as a, as a limit. For example, if you will be fell down, so you will not touch the ground, you will be in a hanging position. So always, it is a safe practice, whenever you are going to anchor the safety harness, you have to anchor above your head. Okay, you cannot hook it up down, because once you will be fell down, so the length of the lanyard is equal to the height of the platform, then there is no use. Always there will be a 2 to 3 meter distance, or the height tape should be there to give them some, the limit for the working of the shock absorber as well.
Sir, are there any quality shock absorbers which can open after very few meters? For example, after 1 meter or 2 meter, it will open from falling.
Yeah,
from the moment of falling.
Yeah, once you will read the shock absorber information, so it will give you the force in terms of kg. Okay, so if this much force will apply, then it will start to opening, because it's a stitch in a layer like this. So it will start. The stitch, it will go to out and it will be start opening. So now the thing is that the maximum load is given on your information is given on the shock absorber. Okay, so the thing is, once it will be started, okay, so this is the maximum point, because it will give you the resistance first. When it is going to start bearing or tearing, it means now the load is up to the maximum level. So you have to check, that's why we are saying, whenever you are going to inspect the safety harness, you have to check the SWL, what is the maximum load it can bear. Okay, for example, if it is designed for 100 kg and you are 150 kg or 120 kg, so you are not advised to use that one. You have to select according to the weight capacity and all these things. Okay.
The shock absorber part is the spring type.
No. Actually, how its construction is, this is made like this. The same lanyard, but they are going to wrap it up, okay, like this, and they put the stitch. Okay, so it depends upon the shock. What is the shocking load? Okay, according to the shocking load, it start, opening like this. Slowly, one by one. First one layer will be open, then the second layer one will be open, then third layer one will be open. So 1, 2, 3. But once it will be fully open, that length you have to consider in your mind.
Okay, so once it is
Yes.
But then come back to the original.
No. Once it will be open, then this shock absorber is you cannot use again.
So you
have to change.
One time use.
Yeah, this is only for the one time. Now this is the old and the now new technology is they are going to use this Hall Elastic device, automatically reliable, you know. We will show you also. So nowadays what they are using is they are working on high or they are going down inside the confined space. They are not using this shock absorber. What they will do, they will remove this one. Okay. They will put the hook of the Hall Elastic device to here. Okay. And then he will go down. It is like a seat bed. Okay. 3-point inertia. So if you are not putting any sudden or shock load, so it will not bother you, it will not block you, you are easy to go. But once you will have some jerk, so the mechanism will start work and it will hold you like this. So this is, you can say, a new modified form. We are calling it Fall Arrestor device, retractable devices. Yes.
Excuse me, after you put on the harness, how can you guarantee and make sure 100% this is not loose harness, especially from the cystical area?
This area? See, the thing is, as I told you, these are coming in the sizes. Okay, now the standard size will come. Now, for example, if you will wear this, you have to adjust by your physiques. So, the fitness or the adjustment of the safety harness means at your comfortable level. Where you are feeling the comfortable.
When you feel comfortable, this means.
Yeah, this is. Yeah, yeah. For example, if now I will wear this, I will make it a little more tightening. Okay? If you will wear, you will make more tightening because it will just get your physique adjustment. But the thing is, from this side and this side, okay, it should be adjusted well. Okay? But from the thigh side, as I told you, this is the old fashion, but still it's in practice. We cannot say that now. We cannot use. But as the Sam said, nowadays comes a new thing with the thigh round. That is much more safer because all the weight will come to your thigh, not to this area. But if you have a land mat safety harness like this, then you have to keep some gain, which will
easily you
that's
my question.
Yeah, normally, see, normally what the safety professionals or the trainers, they are going to advise, at least these two fingers should be there.